33 verses, that means, well, not Monday, Tuesday, but Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday. For 6 days, 33 verses, you can divide into 5 or 6 verses a day. You can read and study 5 or 6 verses every day. Chapter 16 for next week, okay? At your homework. Read it on your own. Think about it. If you want to take notes, bring questions. So for the rest of Proverbs, especially the last part, have more structure and outline. But from now on in Proverbs, I want you to come having already planned and know we're going to read it here, but I want you to read for yourself first and know what it's talking about a little bit better. Okay? So today, we're in chapter 15. Verses 8 on, I think last week we finished verse 8. It's a book of, Proverbs is a book of encouragement. It encourages us to do right. Be wise. Follow God, follow the Lord, follow righteousness, follow what's good, do good, and not the foolish way. This is dumb, evil, wrong, bad. That way. So it's very obvious what the comparisons are. Almost every verse says this and not that. This and not that. So, come on. Chapter 15. I'm going to quote a few verses, but first, do you have any particular verses that you want to ask me about? Or passages? Any comments? Marianne's not here. Proverbs? Proverbs, chapter 15, not Psalms. Proverbs, chapter 15. We did verse 2 last week. Too bad. Too late. You missed it. Sorry. Trains left the station. Tickets no good. Verse 13, about happiness. Rejects it, not just resists it, not just hates it, dislikes it a little bit. He hates it. There is no stronger word than abomination. The strongest word you could use in the Hebrew Bible is something that God gives. He completely salvation unto the Lord. But compare that, right? You have the way of the wicked person, and God hates it. He hates it. Talk about comparisons. This is way beyond compare. And on the other side, what do you have? He loves who? He loveth him that followeth after righteousness. So where do we find righteousness? God will love you. Oh yeah. God loves you. God loved me, John 3:16, sent his son. That's true, but God especially really loves and is happy and is thrilled and is so proud of, I always think of it being like a father. I'm a father and I see my kids. And sometimes my kids make decisions that and I can't tell them it's dumb. I just explain it and teach them. But I see my kids make the right decisions on their own, with no encouragement, without any feedback from me, and it makes me so proud. I say, yes, that's what God does. God sees us following the right path of righteousness, and he's like a proud father. Yay, yes, that's my son. Hooray. That's what we want, right? We want that. And it starts with following the right way. And if you don't follow God's word, then how will we do things the right way? How will we make the right decisions and make God happy? We can't. We have to follow the word of God.
Practice.
Nobody's happy. then they have to fake the smile. Take the picture.
Fake pain.
That's a fake smile. So we're talking about when you have joy in your heart, people can see it. People recognize that you're happy. You're happy. Why are you happy? I have joy in my heart. The old kid's song, I've got the joy, 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 joy. Where? Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. So you have joy in your heart. If you have Christ, then you have hope. That's a promise of salvation. You should be happy. I hate when you go into church. And sometimes when I'm traveling, I go to church and I see people sitting in church and they're just bored. They have no expression. They stand up and sing, no expression. You just stand up and they mumble the words and then they sit down. And usually, who is it? Old people.
No!
Old people. Says it means you're not walking with God. But let me ask you, if I walk with God, who's the best person is walking with God? Is it smiling? So in your mind, maybe if you're happy 80% of the time, maybe 90% of the time, or 50%, 20%, 1%. I don't want 1% happy. I want to raise that percentage. And sometimes sadness is normal. You know, right now the world is going through one of the hardest things that I can imagine. To lose half of yourself. She's lost her husband. And that's tough. So we need to pray for her. That's very tough. Then what? You have sadness. But you have to find joy somewhere. Sometimes sad people are not saved. They're lost. But many times, now, out in the world, especially in America, we have depression. It's all at an all-time high. corporate and medical setting. I've seen many people who are depressed. They don't feel good. Why? I'm depressed. I'm always depressed. We need to find joy. We must find joy. From where? It comes with a relationship with Jesus Christ. Number one, we have number two, having a relationship with other people. That's what you must have. There was a deaf woman who kept asking me all the time, I feel so depressed. I feel lonely. What do I do? Be with other people. You can't stay isolated at home. Why am I lonely? Duh. I have to go out. I have to mingle with other people. I have to build relationships with God first. First I walk with God, and then I go and walk with other people who are like me, and it's best to build relationships with other Christians. I'm going to stop lecturing there. This is not a sermon. That's later. My wife loves this verse. What is this? Vegetables. Who likes this? Would you like this for dinner? Just raw? Without cooking it? No hamburger stuffed inside it? Only this pepper. Raw. Would you agree to that? My wife says, yeah, I would.
What is wrong?
But this would be better to eat just this green pepper with love. With love is better. You know, with someone you love, it's better to have just this than a fat ox steak, fancy steak, the top. Sirloin with everything on it, where there is hatred. Proverbs says, better to have just vegetables, love, people that you love, better than hatred, than hating each other and eating fancy food. I would rather have time to eat with people that I love than with people that don't like each other. So it's important to understand what's the point of this verse. Make some application. What's the point? You're wasting. It's a waste to have arguments, pride, okay? Snobbishness. If you have a problem, have some enemies, some enmity, you have to solve them. You have to forgive each other and make things right. food tastes better.
Right.
With less acid. With less problems. I'm serious. If you have a physical problem, when you're angry, when you're full of hatred, it can cause human being. They worship themselves. They worship their own minds, their own intelligence. And that's sad. I see this a lot, especially on the internet. People with big egos who think they're so smart. And God looks at that and laughs. It's foolishness. I almost underlined that verse. I didn't have time. God will just destroy a proud. God abominates the proud. Another verse, I can't remember this, but we'll see it in the future. Six things that God hates, yea, seven things are an abomination unto him. And two of them are pride. Two of the seven are pride. So, no, not exactly. But one is pride, and then another one is a different word, meaning pride, proud. Proud of the spirit, something like that. But two things out of seven. King Nebuchadnezzar was proud. He ended up eating grass. Establish the border of the widow. What does that mean?
Border.
The border. What's the word? Selfish and greedy, you're going to have trouble. But if somebody gives you a gift and you say, oh, you shouldn't have, that's better. Again, it's attitude, it's humility. That's important. Okay, we're making progress here, right? And say anything at all? I say, oh, first. first let me study this, and then I'll get back to you with an answer, and then I do study it. And then I give my answer. If I already know the answer, it's all right to answer right away. If I've already studied it, and I know it already. But if I'm not just guessing, right, don't just guess. Give a wise answer instead of just spewing out words. That's foolish, and it's wicked. Of wisdom. Accept that. The Lord is exalted and we are lowly. We can never equal Him. So I encourage you to understand what wisdom, what the instruction of wisdom is. What is that? The Bible, from God's Word. You don't want to sit on the throne. Tell me.
Whoa!
should be seeking and desiring humility, because with humility will come honor. And that is the best. Honestly, you know, people honor you and they say, "Oh, Mark, that's good," and it makes me feel good. It does make me feel good, and I'm thankful for that. But what I want is for God to say, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into the joys of the Lord." That's what I want. That's my desire. That's honor. I want to be a servant. I want to be God's servant, and that's all. Okay, last chance for questions on chapter 15, or comments.
No.
Last one, verse 24. The way of life is above to the wise, that he may depart from hell beneath. Shortcut. There's one narrow gate. Only one way. And that's through Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, I thank you for your word. I thank you for Proverbs. What you've given us, what you've taught us. Chapter 15 and the verses that we quoted, learn from them. May it make an impact on us. Give us wisdom to follow you. Help us to choose the wise way and not the foolish way. The good way, not the wicked way. The righteous way, the righteous and just way, and not the bad, unfair way. Help us to follow you and choose wisdom. Desire that wise path in Jesus' name.